Dear students, welcome to session 5 of chapter number 3, working with functions.
Okay students, so in the last session we have studied about the LEGB rule, that is local, enclosing, global and built-in environments. Okay, so now we'll be just looking at one example here. Like def, calsum is the name of the function, x and y are the variables here, s is equals to x plus y, print num1. Now num1 is not the part of this calsum function, right? Return s. Now in the main function, num1 and num2, two variables are created and we have asked the values from the user for these two variables. After this, we have called this calsum function with num1 and num2 variables. So the value of num1 will get copied to x and num2's value will go to y. Okay, now print sum. So this is our function basically. So what happens here? See, first of all, these two variables will be created. Let's suppose num1 gets some value as num1 equals to 10 and num2 also gets some value, num2 is equals to 40. Okay, now this calsum function is created. So x gets the value 10 and y gets the value 40. We have printed the sum. Okay, we have calculated the sum and what we have done here, we have printed num1. Now, num1 is not actually present in the local scope of this definition of calsum. So, because num1 is not present here, so it is going to see it in its global environment. There is no enclosing environment for calsum function. No other function is calling this calsum. So, there is no enclosing environment here. So, it is going to check for the global scope, whether num1 is a part of global scope or not. So num1, it has found that num1 is over here. Okay, so and what is the value of num1? That is 10. So that means it will print 10. Is it clear? And finally it will return the value to sum. Okay, and finally print the value of sum. So what I mean to say here is, if a variable is not present in the local scope, it is going to check out in the respective scopes. In the enclosing one, if enclosing scope the variable is not there, then it will check to the go to the global scope to check for it. And if there also it is not there, then it will go to the built-in environment and check the for the variable there. Okay, so now in the next case, I have taken another example. I've created a function with the name greet and I've just printed hello. Okay, and after this it has used a variable as name. Okay, so name is the variable over here. So because name is not present here within the local scope, so it is going to check, because there is no enclosing scope, so it is going to check out in the global scope. So whether name is name used here in the global scope? No. And in built-in also, no variable with the name is present. So what it is going to see, what it is going to show, it will return an error over here, because in no case it has found the variable name. Okay. So here it will result in an error. Okay. Now, if we use a variable with the same name within a local environment also and in the global environment as well. So now what is going to happen here? It is, if a variable is present in local environment, okay, let's suppose I want to print the value here of tigers. Okay, I've given the value of tigers as 15 and here in the global environment I've given the value of tigers as 95. So what is going to happen? In global scope the value of tigers is 95 only, but in the local scope, because it has found a variable with the name tigers within the local scope only, it is going to print 15 as the value for this print statement. So let's see here what I have done. The program will start from here. Tigers gets the value 95. Print tigers, that means what will be printed? It will print 95. After this, what we have done? We have called the function state1. So what will happen? The state1 function will be called, right? Now what will happen? Tigers get the value 15. So another variable with this name will be created of this local environment. Okay. And then it will print the value of tigers. That means it is going to print the value 15 here. Okay. It will not go to the global scope. First of all, it checks the value in the local scope itself. And in local scope, the value of tigers is 15. So it is going to print 15. Is it clear? And then what happens? It will again come out of the function. And here again it will print the value of tigers. Now in the global scope, what is the value of tigers? That is 95. So that means in the global scope, it is going to print 95. So with the first print statement, 95 will be printed. With the second statement, 15. And the third statement, again 95. So over here, we have noticed one more thing, that even if we are going to change the value of a variable in the local scope, so that value is restricted to the local scope itself. It is not going to change the value in another environments or in another scopes. Got that? Now, if I want that, I want to change the value, or I want to make changes in the value in the global scope only. So what I am going to do is, here I will use a keyword global. So see here, def state 1, I have used the keyword global tigers. This means what? Whatever I am going to do over here within the local scope is going to reflect in all the other environments to wherever tigers is present. Okay. So now what happens? The execution begins from here. Tigers gets the value 95. Print tigers. So 95 is printed. It calls for state 1 function. So if the control goes here. Global tigers. That means now this tiger, which tiger I'm going to use? I'm using the global tigers itself. Now I have changed the value of tigers to 15 and printed it. So 15 will be printed. Now again the control will come here. And again when I'm printing tigers, you can see the changes are reflected here itself. In the first case, no change was made, but in the second case, as I've used global keyword here, that means whatever changes I'm going to make with this variable is going to be reflected everywhere. It will be reflected globally. Okay. So this is the output. Next, we come to mutability and immutability of arguments and function calls. So mutability, immutability, immutable objects are like integer, complex numbers, float, strings, tuples, okay, all these are immutable objects. Okay, so if you can see with this example only, in the first case I have changed the value in the local scope, but in the global scope the change was not depicted. So it means the same thing over here, that if I'm using a variable with the same name or a variable from the global scope also, and I'm changing the value in the local scope, it is not going to be reflected outside, because the variables are actually immutable type. Okay. So let's see one example and it will be more clear to you. Def function 1 AB. Okay. Difference we have calculated. Just an example, I have printed the value A minus B. And now what I've done, I've used a variable from the global scope. X is X plus 5 and printed its value. Right? Now what I'm doing here, in the main function, X gets the value. I've taken the value of X as 10 and Y as 15 initially and printed them. When I print them, so X is 10 only. So 10 and 15 will be printed. Now I've called the function XY. Okay? So the values are passed on to AB, right? Now it will calculate the difference and print it. 10 minus 15 is minus 5. So minus 5 will be printed. Then X is X plus 5. Now X was 10. So 10 plus 5 is 15. Print X, that means 15 will be printed. But just remember that the value of X is changed here, but it is not going to be reflected within the main function in the global scope. when I am again printing the values of x and y in the main function, then x and y are again 10 and 15 only. So you can see here, in the function the value was 15, but outside the function in the global scope the values are not changed, because these were immutable objects. It was an integer. Integer is immutable. So the values of an immutable object does not get changed if we change them in the local scope. Understood? Now we just see an example for a mutable object. So let's suppose I have created a list here. Let's begin from here. I've created a list with values 1, 2 and 4 initially and printed the list. So 1, 2 and 4 is printed, right? Next, I have called the function 1, and I have passed this list in the function. Now what happens? L is the name of list over here, print L. So again 1, 2 and 4 will be printed. Now I have appended one more value to my list, that is 10. And again what I've done, I've extended one more list to it, okay, with values 5 and 3. So if now I'm printing my L, so L is now 1, 2, 4, 10, 5 and 3, right? Now after that, when I return from here, see, return statement is not mandatory when we don't have to return any value, right? So if I'm returning from here, then what happens? Again, if I'm printing it, printing my list in the main function, the list will be the changed one. Got that? Because this is a mutable object, so if any changes are made in the mutable objects, those changes will be reflected globally. Is it clear? So with this, we come to the end of this session. Now I'll meet you in the next session with few of the programs. Thank you.